There are a lot of components that I want to look for when I'm hunting during the early season. So today on Lambbeat, we're to cover a wonderful early season setup that you might want to find on your own place. All right, guys, there's a lot of things that happen during the early season, whether it's what the whitetail needs, or they're just general travel patterns that happen, again, during the early season. Let's classify and clarify what early season really means to me, and probably yourself. But I think of early season as in September to about October 15th. That's the typical time frame that a setup like we're going to discuss today is what I'm looking for in an early season archery setup. So a couple things to keep in mind is generally hot, right? So the ambient temperature outside really dictates how much movement you can experience on a given day. During this time frame, we want to really be mindful of how much distance that they're traveling from bedding location to food source. So spatially, that distance is really important. Sometimes you're forced to get really tight to the bedding, and that can be difficult with it being early season because you don't want to apply too much pressure with it being the first part of season and bump deer. But we know that because it's hot outside, deer aren't traveling great distances generally from bedding to food. And oftentimes we want to find a north slope, east slope that has some shade component that's generally going to have lower temperatures during the daytime. So that's generally the preferred bedding location for whitetails. And if you can find that in close proximity to a food source, whether that be mass production or whether that be a clover plot or an alfalfa field, whatever the case may be, or a cut corn field, you want to be sandwiched in between that. So a couple other things that I really want to look for too is the fact that it can still be dry late summer, early fall. And so having a water source that is close to that setup or in between that setup might be a great funnel, a great pinch to capture deer and get them within bow range as they're leaving the bedding and moving into the food. So what I'm standing at is one of my favorite locations for this early season time frame. What you can't see from right here, but hopefully through some aerial drone footage, is there is a dense bedding area back in here. We've got shade component. There's a lot of forage in there, a lot of structure, but it's on an east-facing slope. So that's roughly the start of it, 80 yards from where we're at right here. Tree stands back behind me. As deer filter out from that bedding area, they have this water source, this permanent water source, freestanding, that they can come in, get a drink if it is really hot, and then move their way through this perennial clover stand. It is a small strip of clover. However, I like having it because generally, even if it burns up during the summertime frame, by the time season gets rolling, we've got enough dews that and cooler nights that the clover is going to pop back. So I have a perennial source close to food, close to shade lines. This gets shaded pretty early in the afternoon as well. So we got bedding 80 yards away, or the start of bedding 80 yards away, water source, perennial clover. So as deer have the ability to get that drink, be in the shaded kind of clover strip, then we translate out into the larger destination food source. This food source can change greatly from year to year. Right now, just have seeded alfalfa. Alfalfa is an incredible crop during the summer months and during the early to mid-fall. You can go and broadcast brassicas and such into your alfalfa if you choose to. We'll have another video talking about alfalfa establishment and management here coming up on Lambbeat. So tune into that if you want to learn more about that crop. But we've got lots of early season forage, small kind of secluded area that gets shade before they transition out into a large destination. So we've got a lot of really good components that I want to find in an early season tree stand setup. Close range, close proximity to these animals, whether it's from the shot opportunities, but also from bedding and destination food source. One thing to also keep in mind is the actual stand setup. Make sure you have plenty of back cover. Luckily, we still have leaves on the trees, but you want to find yourself kind of in that shaded dark hole. And you can see that right back up behind me in that cedar mess. That's even though the deer are in close proximity moving through, be hard for you to get picked off because of that setup, because of the back cover, even though they're going to be 15 to 20 yards away from you max as they move through this water source out into the destination food plot. So that's what I'm looking for. Hopefully you guys got a setup just like that that you can hunt this year, but best wishes to you during this hunting season.